students, welcome back to my YouTube channel Remedial Classes. Please do share and subscribe because I'll be uploading prose and poetries including grammar of higher secondary, first year and second year. Please stay updated. Today I have come with Lost Spring by Jung, second part. The first part I have already discussed in my last video. Please you can go and check it. So let's get started. Here the heading is I want to drive a car. Mukesh, he insists on being his own master. He says that I want to drive a car. The author asks, do you know anything about cars? He says that I will learn how to drive a car. But his dream seems to loom in the mirage of his deserted street of Firozabad where he lives. Mirage means when you are thirsty in a deserted area, you feel that there is a water nearby, but when you reach that area, you find that there is no water. So his dream is like that. Here in every houses their occupation is bangle making, and the bangles are seen all around, and Mukesh's family is one of them. In this area, 20,000 children works in the glass blowing industry in a high flame in a dingy cell, which is an illegal activity, but nobody knows. The guardians do not know. If the authorities knows, they may take away all these 20 children out of this dingy cell. But their main work is bangle making, and Mukesh is also one of them. He works in a bangle making industry. Mukesh is very happy in accompanying the author to his house. He says that his house is reconstructed. The author follows him on the way. There is stinking lane and garbage all here and there, and the houses are also made of broken walls, crumbling walls means broken, everything is crumbling, and means wobbly doors. The doors are not fitted, it is very loose, and no windows. And she observes that human beings and animals are coexisting together, like as if in the primitive ages how animals and men coexisted. While crossing several houses, suddenly Mukesh stops at one of the houses. He bangs the door and then pushes it with his leg, and the author and Mukesh gets inside the house. The author sees that a frail young lady whose eyes were filled with smoke, but she was smiling. She was cooking something in a wooden stove. The sizzling spinach she was cooking, but she was very frail. That means she was very weak. And whenever any elderly man comes, she goes behind the broken wall and covers her face in a veil. It is the as tradition demands. They have to cover their face. She, though very young age, she was in charge of Mukesh, her husband and Mukesh's father. And she has attained the dignity of being a bahu, that means being a newly wedded wife. Mukesh's father says that in spite of doing such hard labor, he had done nothing. He had only taught his children how to make bangles. He could not renovate his house. He could not give education to his children. And then Mukesh's grandmother says to the author that her husband had bangle making all throughout the years, and finally he had lost his eyes. She says that can a God given lineage be ever broken? That means God had given them the art of making bangles only, and it has come down through generations after generations, so it will never be broken. She says that it is their fate. So next, moving on to the story, the author says that there was a young girl dabbed in pink dress. That means the dress was also faded, but her hands were moving mechanically and she was making bangles. In all the courtyards, in all that area, in every houses, only bangles are seen everywhere, in the streets, in the courtyard, in every houses. There are peri green color bangles, royal blue color bangles, golden color bangles, and all the colors that are available in the rainbow are found here. The lady, the author says that the Savita, about Savita, she says that does she know the sanctity about the bangles? Sanctity means purity and holiness about the bangles. She thinks that after some days she will also be wearing bangles and her hand will be draped in red color. That is the custom of the Indians, that every Indian woman, every married woman wear bangles. And the lady who was sitting beside her, the old lady, she was also wearing bangles, but her eyes had no light. That means she has no cheerfulness in her eyes. She was sad and her eyes were also she has lost her eyesight. The author was very sad about that. That old lady's husband says that all throughout his life he had made bangles and he was the only one to build a house. Here in Firozabad, people do not dare to even construct a house because they are very poverty stricken and they are in perpetual poverty. And the young men are also like that. Everyone doesn't dare to raise their voice. They do not associate themselves into cooperative. The author asks some young boys, why don't you associate yourselves into a cooperative? Why are your bangles in the hands of brokers and middlemen? They purchase your bangles in low rate, but they sell it in a very high rate. So why do you allow all these things to happen? At that time, the young man said that we cannot, even if we make a cooperative, we are the only ones who are hauled by police and we are dragged into the jail. So we do not dare to do that. So here only the spiral talks, means only talking, they can only talk about all this, but in reality nothing works in practical because they have no leaders, they have no one to guide them. So the author says that she finds here two distinct worlds. One world is about the poverty stricken people and the other world is about the sahukars, the middlemen, the policemen, the brokers, etc. Now again, the boy Mukesh, he says that he would be a motor mechanic. Then he said that he will learn how to be a motor mechanic. He will go to a garage, but the garage is also very much far away from his place. He said that he will walk up to that place and learn the technique of motor mechanic. The author asks him, do you want to fly aeroplane? He simply smiled and put down his hand. He does not dream of flying an aeroplane because it is too much high. Very few aeroplanes fly in Firozabad. So what did you understand from this story? That these people are in perpetual poverty. But when we compare Mukesh's story with the previous one, Saheb's story, Saheb has already accepted his fate, but here we see that Mukesh, he dares to dream, though it is a mirage, but still he dares to dream. He thinks of doing something great. So here ends the story. Thank you.